Of course, we do need to play basic sound clips. For grids, though, we have robots moving around a 2D world, making noise and causing mayhem. It doesn't make a lot of sense for a sound on the opposite side of the game map from the player to be just as loud as the one right next to them. So it's not quite enough for a game like grids. What we need is to also add the ability to adjust the volume based on the game state. And that solves the problem I just mentioned. With web audio, we can adjust the volume of sounds based on how far they are from a player's position on the screen. This provides a much more realistic sound environment than you could achieve with, for example, the audio element. You can think of a lot more situations where it could be cool to have more involved sound effects. Maybe you want to apply an echo effect based on how sound reflects on the map walls, or apply a Doppler effect based on the velocity of a player or a projectile. This can quickly get pretty involved. In grids, we simplify this and go for basic volume changes. The point is, you need to think about what level of sound complexity is right for your game and your team.